Hi children, we have come to the third part of the first chapter EVS in third standard. We have seen how animals are all grouped into herbivores, carnivores, omnivores and scavengers. We have also seen different kinds of food habits in different animals. It's a matter of surprise, I said, a matter of wonder as to how this nature runs. Now we will come to the third lesson. See, lots of animals we keep in our houses. You may have your pet cat. You may have a pet dog in the house. You may have cows in the shed. You may have one, two, or you may be running a dairy where you may have 40, 50 cows. If you have a horse carriage, then you will have a horse too. If it's a temple, they may have an elephant. Some have beehives, then bees are our domestic animals. Ducks become our domestic animals. What are domestic animals? We look after those animals with all kindness. We'll be kind to them. We take care of them. And they too serve us. If you have a cat, it will see that you don't get disturbed by rats. To see that rats are out, you get a cat in. So you feed the cat, you look after the welfare of the cat, because in the welfare of the cat lies your welfare. We have cows. They give us milk. Nutritious milk. The milk of the cow enables a baby to grow. Mom of the baby may have enough milk or not, but cow's milk will supplant that, will supplement that. Have a glass of milk in the morning, a milk glass of milk in the evening, will keep you hale and healthy and strong. Milk has all nutrients in it. Milk is very rich in nutrients. It's a very well nature made food. How? The cow has prepared that food in its body for its calf, for its young one. So the milk has to be rich. For the next 3 months or 6 months, the calf will grow up with the milk of its mother. Just as in human beings, the babies grow with the nutritious milk from their mothers. Milk is always very rich in content. So you have to be very kind to the domestic animals you have in the house. If you have a shed to tie them up, keep them tight, the shed should be very clean. It should have proper lighting. You should feed the animals with proper food. You may have to provide them with cereals. You may have to provide them with oil cakes. Oil cakes are ready in the market. They are made from the vegetable oils, those cakes. You provide them green grass from the field. If you can take them out, you can make them graze. If you can't graze, then what should you do? You have to get green grass. You have to get dry grass of wheat, jowar or rice. You have to feed them. When they fall ill, you have to get a veterinary doctor. You should treat those animals as if they are your own children, your own sons and daughters. You should go to them, talk to them, love them, show your affection, and they will serve you very well. They give you lot of happiness, lot of pleasure. See, this is about the domestic animals you keep. You should never hurt them. You should always feel and function as if they are your own kith and kin. Okay, now about the feeding habits of animals worldwide. No animal is a separate being. We are all dependent on each other. Humans, they may be consuming plant food, or they may be consuming meat and other types of flesh of animals, cook and eat. So some of the people are vegetarians, you call them as veg. Some people are non-vegetarian, you say non-veg. Sometimes you ask, no, are you vegetarian, are you veg? No, I take meat, he says. I eat fish, he may say. Veg and non-veg. In the animal world as such, all animals are dependent on each other. And ultimately, the animal world is dependent on the plant world. All these herbivores, they eat grass, they graze, they eat grass and they grow up. Now let us see how all the animals are connected with each other. Here you see, you have plants. You have plants here. Now amidst these plants, you have the grasshoppers. Grasshoppers, they lay their eggs there. Larvae come out. Larvae feed on the leaves. Then even as they grow up, they eat the leaves. And grasshoppers live on plants. Thus, grasshoppers are dependent on grass. I have taken one linear example. Grasshoppers are dependent on grass. Now see the beauty. Grasshoppers are the food of frog. Frog stays quiet. When a grasshopper comes near, suddenly it sticks out its tongue, catches hold of the grasshopper and it swallows. See, the grasshopper is the food of the frog. Frog is the food of the snake. How do snakes live? Snakes are carnivores. So it awaits the arrival of a frog, then catches hold of it, gets it bound in its body, or it catches with its teeth, small teeth in the mouth, except for the venomous ones. If it's a venomous snake, the long ones, it holds and it will start swallowing the whole frog. If it's a small frog, it swallows. If it's a big frog, it may even twirl around the frog and hold it, then start eating from its one end. From the head part or the leg part, it will start swallowing. See, snakes eat frogs. Snakes are eaten by eagles. You see the eagle here. Eagle flying in the sky. It keeps on going round and round, hunting for small animals on the ground. When they get an animal, it suddenly hovers down. It hovers down, catches the animal and flies away, goes and sits on a tree and eats the snake. The eagle may eat snakes, the eagle may even eat a frog. See, all these are linked. I have given one strain of animals linked to each other. It's a chain. Don't you see it's a chain? Green plants, grasshopper, grasshopper to frog. Frogs are eaten by snakes. Snakes are eaten by eagle. This is the chain created by nature. We call it as, see the heading here, food chain. It is called as food chain. It's not as simple as I say. The frog may not eat only grasshoppers. It may eat many other organisms. Frog, snake. It may eat a rabbit too. It may eat except different animals, small animals. So these animals have different kinds of food again in nature. We have taken one example each and connected them in a linear way. What is linear? As if it is on one single line. It is on one single line, no? Then we call it as food chain. All the animals and plants, they are all interlinked. It's a web. We are dependent on other animals and plants for our food. It is the secret of nature. Thank you.